Hello student, welcome to my class of data file handling for class 12th. In Python we will learn the CVS file, that is 9 parts of the file handling. So its content are as follow. The first content, what is CSV file. Then second, writing CSV file with CSV module. Then appending a CSV file, reading a CSV file with CSV module, searching in a CSV file, and practice and session, okay, and question answer for the homework. So let's begin with the what is CSV file. So student, in earlier time I have explained you what is CSV file, so let's do it again. So actually CSV file is known as comma separated value file, okay. It is a type of plain text file that uses a specific structuring to arrange the tabular data, okay. Because it is a plain text file, it can contain only the textual data, I am saying actual data, okay. So student, you can understand actually CSV file is a Excel file, okay, in which data in format in a tabular format, either in row or column format, okay. And data is actually in tabular format, so it contain only actual text, okay. That is, that text can be a printable content like the ASCII code or Unicode characters, okay. The structure of CSV file is given away, but it's the name normally, okay. CSV file use a comma to separate each value data. Here we can structure look like this, okay student. So first of all, I will to tell you how a CSV file is going to be formatted. So CSV file is formatted with the help of comma. Comma, that is, it is known as delimiter, which set the which actually provide the separation from one value to another value. So let's see how looks it. So here you can see in an example, here is column 1 name comma, column 2 name comma, column 3 name, okay. So last value do not have comma. So here first row data 1, then comma, first row data 2, then comma, first row data 3, comma. So like same way we are performing, I am to say, CSV file, okay student. So the comma separated value actually stored to the Excel sheet, that is in a form of tabular format, okay, that is used for programs. So next we have to understand what do you, okay, where do CSV file come from. Actually CSV file mainly useful for the programs which used to analyze data, understand data, okay, and after that what operation they will perform. For example, in Python matplot library is there which can visualize the data either in a tabular format or bar chart, okay. Number of the operation are available there, okay. So usually a program generate that CSV file and require that also, okay. So now we have to come to the next one, writing a CSV file with CSV mode, okay. So here you can see that an example, we need to import a module CSV first, and then after that with function we have open a file along with CSV extension with write mode, okay, as employ a file. Then after that, here you can see that writer method we have to use, okay, and then after that CSV writer, okay, CSV model we have call, then after dot writer is a function of CSV module, that is CSV, that is library, and then after that inside that we have to pass this particular file, okay, and then comma. Here is delimiter, as I told you it is comma separated file, I am to say value file, so we have to provide delimiter equals to comma, and then after that the row writer method, then write row, and within that we have to pass a list separated by comma. Student, notice that one thing, first row always will be a column header, I am say table header of the particular table. I am to say what should be column header for row number, name, email ID. Here I am going to add a number, okay, that is employee writer dot write row 1 comma Kamal, then its email ID. So student, we have to do it practically. So to do that, I have to open a Google Colab, okay. So I will open a new file, okay, new notebook. It will take few seconds due to the internet connectivity. Now I am going to rename this particular file as a CSV program. Okay student, now I am going to just first of all doing one thing, that is import CSV, okay student, and I will put the comment as a documentation, creating a CSV file, okay student. Now I have imported this one thing. Now what I will do, I will use a with function. In with function I will open a file. Suppose that my file name is today csv dot csv. Okay, so you can see student file name is today csv, okay, an extension csv, then separated comma. I am going to write it, so write mode, and then after that I will provide here new line. Okay, new line equals to within comma as f. Here is f is a file. Okay, so you have understand already. Okay, same method I have applied with open as f. Here is today.csv file. Okay, write mode new line equals to single comma single column start and close, and then after that I will create a new variable, that is writer. Okay student, you can say that writer also, but I'm only using writer. So here csv dot writer, inside that I will pass this file object f. Okay, then here I will provide delimiter equals to comma, okay, within single quote comma, then I will write dot write row. Okay, inside that I will pass the this one thing column header. Okay, for example roll number, then comma name. Okay student, here I can say that student name I also. Okay, then after that email ID. And then I will write another row also, writer dot write row. In this I will also pass a value. If suppose that my value is 1, roll number is 1, student name Kamal Kant, and then email address is gmail.com. Second is a student name, that is writer dot write row. Okay student, within that I am going to pass value like roll number 2, and then after that Abhijit Gupta, within that email address abhi@aol.com. okay, @aol.com, it is also one of them. Okay, and next student name writer dot write row, within this I will provide roll number 3. Okay student, here is name Himmat Singh. Okay, then after that its email ID. So now you can see student, I have just used a write row method and I am going to run it. Okay student, so wait for its output. So now we can check whether the file is created. Click on this folder and double click on it. So now you can see in next one thing, you can see the data is stored in tabular format, where is the roll number, student name, email ID in a form of table column header, and then 1 to 3 as roll number, name as name. Okay, and then email address like this only. Okay, now we are going to just read this particular file. Okay student, I'm going to say append the file, so I'm going to just put another one code to append the file. So I will add the comment appending csv file. Okay student, now I do not need to import csv again because whole shell allow me to import the csv. So I will do one thing, I will just use with open, the file name will be same like above, today csv. Okay, I think it is in capital letter. Okay, then after that extension csv. Okay student, here if you will append mode, same thing I will put here, new line equals to single quote as f. Okay student, now I will create a writer. Okay, here CSV module, then after that writer, within that I will pass the function, file object f, and then after that I will pass the delimiter equals to within single quote there will be comma. Okay, and I am going to add a new row. Suppose that I am going to add two student roll number, I am to say 4 and 5. So what will be happen, look at here. So I will add writer dot write row. Okay student, within that I will pass two student detail whose roll number 4 and the name is Angita Sharma and email address abc@gmail.com. okay student, and now new student, that is writer dot write row, within that I will pass roll number 5. Student, we can pass the integer also, but I am consider as a string only. Okay, so here we are passing only a string. So here Akshita. Okay, then after that email address gmail.com. okay, now we are going to just run it. Okay, so let's see what will happen. I have appended two data also, so let's see in double click also. So now you can see 5 student record has been added here. Rest 3 student detail already added in creation of file, Kamal Khan, Abhijit Gupta, Himmat Singh. Now Akshita and Ankita detail has been added here. Now we have an understand how to add, I am to say append, and how to create the file. So next thing we are going to do, how to read a CSV file. Okay, how to read a CSV file. So read a CSV file, I will do one thing, same thing. So I will add the reading, add the comment reading a CSV file. Okay student, so what I will do, I have to import the CSV module, but it in the whole program CSV already imported. So what I will do, I will open this file again with function. The file name is today.csv.csv, then after that read mode. Okay student, inside that I can use the new line also, but let it be, there is no need to affect of that as reading time. So this one f, and then after that what we are going to do, we are having a reader object. So what we have to do, we have to use CSV. Okay student, at the writing time here is writer method is there, I mean to say function is there, but reading time reader object reader method is there. So what we do, reader. Okay, within that we have to pass the file object. Okay, and then after that delimiter, we have to pass the same thing, delimiter equals to within comma single quote. And now we can't read like the, here is a function in write method write row, but in reading time there is another one function. Okay, so what we are going to do, suppose that I have taken a line as a variable 0, so we are actually traverse the all record through the loop, that is for loop. So here row is a function in reader object. Okay, then after that I am going to print what thing, first of all line number, then comma, here is row. Okay student, and a part of that one thing, I will increase the line by 1. So let it be, let look the answer what will print. So now you can say student, a particular row has come 0 1 2 3 4 5. Okay, for first row consider a 0 row, so row number, student name, email id. So here you can see that number of value as roll number comes. Okay, name are printing and email address also are going to print. So now we are going to search a particular CSV file. So how to do this, perform the search. Okay student, so I am going to just add a new cell code. So student, at the reading time you are doing the searching operation. So I am going to add a new comment, that is searching in what thing? CSV file. Okay student, so what we have to do, we have to open a particular file with function. Okay, within that the file name is I think today csv.csv. okay, here is csv's extension. Then after that we have to apply read mode, and then suppose that we are going to try to delimit the function, okay, with a delimiter, okay, that is come also. So no need to worry about that one thing, so let it be. Then as f, okay, within that we have to use a reader. Okay, then csv is a module. Inside that there is a function, that is reader. I have to pass file as object f, okay, and then after that delimiter equals to comma. And then after that what I have to do, first of all I have to ask the user which value you are going to searching for. Okay student, so here search data as a variable where this user will ask this one thing input. Here I am simply typing, please enter the roll number. Okay, to search the student detail. Now what to do, we have to traverse that one thing simply by for same method row in a reader. Okay, and then after that we are going to check. Okay, so what we are going to check, if row index of 0 is double equals to row number. Why I'm going to do this? Because I want to print the student detail along with the column header also. Okay, so that's why I'm going to just print it. So what I will do, print here is row. Okay student, and now rest of part, what I will do, I will do elif part. In elif part I will ask, if row of 0th element is double equals to, if you have entered the roll number, so we have to search data. Okay, if it is found, then print what thing, that is row. Okay student, otherwise else nothing, I mean say no need to think about any problem. I mean to say we have to just pass, because we are not doing any action here. So let's see what will happen. If I am going to run it, okay, it will, okay, there is a problem in delimiter, spelling mistake is there. So now we are running this one thing, it is asking me, okay, here please enter the roll number to search the detail. Suppose that if I am going to search the detail of 4th student roll number, so here you can see that a student who having the roll number 4 has printed the details here. If you are running this one again and we are going to search the second number of student detail, so you can see second roll number student detail has been printed. And now suppose that if you are going to just search the such kind of detail which are now existing, okay, it will not print anything else to me. Okay, so what I will do, I will do nothing, I will just say here what thing, there is no such detail, okay, in our list. So what I do, break, okay, which will never search the further details, because if the content is found, there is no need to search the another content. I'm say traverse the other conditions. So I have just printed the break function here. I'm say break here, okay, which breaks my particular content. I'm say traversing mechanism, okay, and that's it only. So we have learned how to search the content with easy mode. So now you can see. Okay student, so student, we have learned how to perform the searching operation. So let's do it theoretically first. So student, you know how to write the CSV file. We have to import CSV module, and then we have to open a file with open function. Okay, and here write mode and employee name, that is file object. Here is writer. Employee writer is a variable, it's a defined variable. Here is writer is function, okay, of CSV module. In that we are going to pass the file object, employee file, and delimiter, that is comma, okay, within single quote. And then after this one thing, employee writer is a variable, then after that write row method allow us to write the row. Okay, first row always should be a write and say column header details, and second and further one will be details like 1, 2, 3. We can put the roll number without a number also. Okay, now how to update this one thing? So update appending, I'm going to say updating this one thing. So we have to just import the CSV file, okay, append mode, and other part will be same, okay, but first row will not never contain this particular line. It I mean to say roll number, name, this one thing. So make sure that when you are appending the detail, you have to only enter the detail of the student. So I mean to say record only. Okay, now reading a CSV file, reading a CSV file is quite easy, as like the writing. Okay, we have to pass the reader mode, new line we can post there. I mean say paste there single quote, it is optional. Okay, optional argument, CSV file. Okay, so here is a, you can see that CSV reader object function is there, which pass the CSV file and delimiter, and after that we can just count the number also, it's up to you, and traverse each particular line, okay, and print the line number along with its incrementation. Searching, so student, you can see that if I ask the user to input the number, okay, suppose that in this condition I have not asked the user to enter which roll number you are going to search. I have just in hard coding I have placed 1, it will only search the row, I mean to say row 0 of roll number 1. If it is true, then it will print found data, otherwise not. So here you can see I have opened the file, okay, and the reading mode I have skipped here, reading mode not mentioned here, okay, and CSV reader and reader method, CSV file delimiter, and line number 0 or line count 0, and for row in CSV file reader. Okay, so we are going to traverse that one thing, and if row 0 double equals to 1, if there is existence of roll number 1, then it will print the found data, otherwise not. Okay, or we can just print a row. So student, now question and practice for the homework, students. So first thing, write the program, okay, in Python program for the day, okay, whatever we have done today. Then second one thing, write a program to store a detail on CSV file in a following details. So what should be following details with beta? This one thing, roll number, name, class, section, subject 1, subject 2, subject 3, subject 4, and subject 5, student. So here a number of the columns are increased, okay, student. So you have to enter the number of the details that I mentioned here. Then after that, you have to go to question number 3. All questions are related to each other from question number 2 to 5, okay. Write a program to append the student detail also using CSV, okay. I have teach you how to do that. You have to just do it again, okay, in the term of this particular questions. Now write to print a CSV file. Yes, student, you have to just print, I mean to say read the file of CSV file that is given above, and search the file content and print it. Okay, student, so if it is dynamic, that will be well and good. So keep doing well, student, and a practical and homework session, student, whatever the program you'll do, send it to my email ID. Okay, till then, thank you, and have a nice day, student.